Do you want to turn an old mobile air conditioner into a water-to-water heat pump that can give a significant contribution to the winter heating of your home? It's a game changer for do-it-yourself enthusiasts looking to create an efficient system at a fraction of the cost of a commercial water-to-water heat pump. And today I will show you exactly how to do it. Hello and welcome back to the channel. I'm Norbert Vaassen, energy engineer. In today's video, we are diving into an exciting project that repurposes a small mobile air conditioner. I started this project already in video number 62, where I dismantled such a small air conditioner. And today, I will convert it into a water-to-water heat pump. Those have the advantage that you can store a lot of cold and also a lot of heat, or both. Much more than in air, which comes out of the original air conditioner. It has the advantage that also the central heating works with water. So this air conditioner becomes compatible with the central heating. I will replace the whole gas heater. And the unique point in this video is that I explain how to use not only the heat or not only the cold, but both of them. And that explains better in video number 62. The heat pump that I show is not enough for the whole house. Therefore, I show how to use two of them. Together with the thermal storage, there will be probably enough for many situations and also many houses. That's because these two big tanks can give a lot of heat in a short time if you charge them before. This setup can dramatically improve your home's energy efficiency. It moves us away from fossil fuels, and it's also an alternative of electrical energy storage. Usually, going away from fossil fuels through electrification is not so good if you use then electrical energy for direct one-to-one conversion into heat. And that's because of the thermodynamic degradation of electrical energy. But the heat pump makes it good again, especially if you use both the hot and the cold side. So let's get started. Explanation and advantages. Most people don't realize that water has one of the highest heat storage capacities of any material. This makes it an ideal medium to work with when you are dealing with a limited temperature range that a heat pump operates in. And that's between 0 and 50 degrees to keep him happy. With this project, I'm taking a standard mobile air conditioner that consumes only 700 watts of power, of electrical power. But it gives much more. Instead of cooling air, which you do normally with an air conditioner, I'm going to use it to move heat between two different 1000 liter water containers. So I'm not making heat. I'm just taking it from one place to another. And that has another efficiency. That means also that one container cools down and the other heats up, because I'm taking the heat from here to there. Instead of using electrical resistors, it creates about 2.5 times this 700 watts in heat flow. So simply said, I cool down the cold container with 1750 watts and I heat at the same time the warm container with 1750 watts. But together that's 3500 watts. So that's 5 times the consumed power of the compressor. Here's how it works. The heat pump's condenser and evaporator are submerged in a small water box. This box has two separate compartments, one for hot water and one for the cold water. Water falls by gravity through the hoses into the large tanks and pumped back to the compartments in the water box again. Since the copper pipes in the compressor are too short to directly connect to the large tanks, this setup lets us use the water box as a transfer medium. What are the advantages of this configuration? Cost effectiveness. Water-to-water heat pumps are usually very expensive devices. Converting a small, second-hand, mobile air conditioner not only saves on the electricity bill or the natural gas bills, but it increases also the worth through do-it-yourself enhancements. In October, many people want to get rid of these mobile noisemakers, but we will eliminate the noisy fans. You'll certainly find many of them on the second-hand market and try to get them for 70 euros or so. Heat storage. With this setup, I'm storing more energy efficiently. Water's high energy storage capacity exploits the small temperature difference between the hot and the cold side of the heat pump in the best way. Both big water tanks can store about 12 kilowatt hours of thermal energy if you use them with the 10 degrees Celsius temperature difference between the supply and return duct of your cold or heat radiator or fan coil or whatever consumes this hot or cold water. How much do you pay for a 12 kilowatt hour lithium battery? That might be 12 grand. Flexible use. This system can be adapted to different applications like central heating and cooling, showers or washing machines. You can store heat from renewable energy sources instead of selling it for 5 cents per kilowatt hour to the grid. But you can also take and store electricity from off-peak hours and consume it when you need it most. If you are excited to see this transformation and want to see more do-it-yourself solutions, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Share this exciting idea with your friends. They will be amazed that you double the efficiency of the small air conditioner and heat a home with only two of those small air conditioners to get a 1.5 kilowatt consumption. You will see this later in the video, so please stand by. And if you have any questions or ideas, just leave them in the comments. Now let's get our hands dirty, but not bloody, so please use gloves, because these heat exchangers, they have very sharp edges. Preparing the water box. I am starting by securing the heat pump's condenser and the evaporator inside this water box. I've divided it into two compartments, one for the hot side and one for the cold side. To avoid water exchange across the insulation material, I put bags around the heat exchangers. You can do it better by using thick plastic and silicones to seal the insulation wall from the two sides. Fixing the compressor. I could fix the compressor directly onto the water box to create a compact 10 kg unit, plus of course the 30 kg of water. That's easier to handle and integrates seamlessly with the water box. And if you have these two units, you can also use them to regulate the amount of PV energy which is fed into this system. So you can switch 1, 2 or 0 of these units. The compressor is an electric element, so please make it safe and separate it from water. An earth connection and even a differential circuit breaker is very important for your safety. And isolate the box from the vibrations so that it will make less noise. Now connecting the water box to the large water containers. I'm linking both compartments of this water box to separate 1000 liter water tanks. The cold water is picked up from the bottom of the 30 liter water box because there it is colder. The same with the upper water surface in the warm compartment where the temperature is maximum. Sucking away the water at these extreme temperatures from the heat exchangers of the heat pump, you make its working conditions better and he will reward you with high efficiency. Next week, I try to connect this system to the central heating. But I will show also a connection to a fan coil or even the cooling system of the car engine. I hope you like and share the video. And of course also subscribe so that you don't miss next week.